Deputy Katelyn Bailey with Wasco County Sheriff's Office. As part of being a deputy, I'm also representative for the union. I'm an executive board member, and I'm here tonight to present the Wasco County Law Enforcement Association Scholarship. As I stated, this is a fairly new scholarship and is only our third year awarding this scholarship. We have struggled to get it out there and make it known, but thankfully the school has allowed us to present tonight. This scholarship is offered to a graduating high school senior who is children or grandchildren of law enforcement families currently working within Wasco County. This includes Wasco County Sheriff's Office, Wasco County 911, Wasco County Community Corrections, NORCOR, and the Dalles City Police and Oregon State Police Troopers assigned to the local command. Students must be planning on attending an accredited college, university, community college, or trade school the summer or fall immediately following their high school graduation. These applicants must provide 3 character references and write a short essay, approximately 500 words, describing what it means to grow up in and be a part of a law enforcement family. I'm gonna say the name of who won, but I would like this person to stay in their seat until the end because I have some great things to say about them. So this year we are honored to be presenting this scholarship to Kendall Webber. Kendall's mother, Amy, is a 911 dispatcher for Wasco County Communications. Amy has been a dispatcher for approximately 13 years. Being in the law enforcement community means we spend countless hours together under high stress situations helping our community. This also means we spend countless hours away from our families to help other families. This is a selfless act that we are called to do, but it is also a selfless act our families must also commit to. Those of you who know a first responder know that we come home sometimes tired, stressed out, moody, cranky, and kind of withdrawn. Our families have learned to adapt with us and provide us support through these times. They must also find ways to keep on going in their own lives, and sometimes that means doing it without us. Not only do we sacrifice a lot, but so do our families. Kendall has had some other sacrifices to make this past year. As I'm sure most of you know, Amy suffered a stroke at work and was out on medical leave for a while. This presented Kendall with the opportunity to stand up and provide more help to her family. Kendall was patient through these times and was able to help support her family through this unexpected reality. Not only did Kendall do this, she also spent many hours babysitting for other law enforcement families, spending many nights in the dispatch center doing homework because she needed her mom's help, and playing 2 sports, both of which she considered continuing into college. And as a previous swim coach, I'm super excited to say she chose to go to Southeastern Community College and keep swimming. Go Kendall. It's been such a pleasure to watch Kendall grow into the wonderful young woman she is today. We wish her the best of luck in all her future endeavors. And with that, I present the scholarship to Kendall. Thank you, everybody.